I'm sure that frequent Final Cut Pro users would love to have the content of their videos and their stills and their audio automatically analysed for types of images, as well as to search for words in the audio content. In this video, I'll review an app released on the 10th of May 2021 called Final Cut Pro VideoTag. And if you get in quick, it's available as a launch special at €4.99. That's before the 1st of June when it increases to €9.99. Whatever price you pay, it's a steal. Sure, Final Cut Pro will look for close-up, medium and wide-angle shots and will create keywords for them. But imagine having clips analysed to find the keyword created for a video or a still image with a bridge in it, or a video with yachts being in an automatically created keyword, sailboat. And as an added bonus, this app will create a transcript for a voiceover video. I'm Bruce McBride and I'm available for one-on-one personal tuition with Final Cut Pro, and that's over the internet. Just click trainingfinalcutpro.com. In this review, I intend to show my impressions of FCP VideoTag rather than go into the details of how to use the app. The developer from Ultimedia has very comprehensive and very clear instruction tutorials, so click in the description below for the links for those. And I'd also like to be upfront and tell you that I've not been paid to produce this tutorial, though they did provide me with a copy for this review. The impressions were good. I found the installation process seamless. The app appeared in the downloads folder and needed to be dragged into the applications folder. On first launch, extra files are downloaded, which takes no more than a minute or so. And of course, the Apple security comes into play and the app asks for approval to use voice recognition, and a simple click on continue is all that's required. And from there, you're ready to drag media files into the application window. And it should be pointed out that this whole process takes some time, but generally not too much, unless it's an audio file. The reason to use the app is to pre-analyze your media and to create keywords in Final Cut. Think of it as your assistant to find content in your video and your voiceover clips. Just as you would not expect your assistant to instantly analyze the clips for you, neither will FCP VideoTag. The video and still images are analyzed in reasonable time, but the audio files, on the other hand, can take some time, and then you'll need to teach the app what words you want to ignore. This will become less of a chore as the app remembers the words that you've hidden in previous sessions. And what I'm trying to say here is that you need to set the app in motion and then go away and do something else. The app's not something you want to use if you're in a hurry to start editing. And as with anything, planning is an important part of the professional editing process, and in my mind, one of the key advantages of this app is it doesn't just create Final Cut keywords for your current projects, but it also keeps a database of those tags and keywords so that you can call up for future projects. I'll show you that as we go through. Let's look at an exercise where the app is analysing a folder of videos, stills and audio. The first thing, though, is the language that you're going to use. Not so much an issue for video and stills, but imperative for having voiceovers recognised. It comes preset at US English. So to change the language, even to another version of English, that's Australian, British, etc., will make a difference, particularly with the spellings of the script. And I'm sure it'll make a difference to how words are recognised with different pronunciations. Let's take the different ways of saying Caribbean. Is it pronounced Caribbean or Caribbean? You can also tweak the preferences here, but that's beyond the scope of this video. So let's look at the Finder window, and here's a folder with video, still and audio. And that is simply dragged into the apps window, and all you need to do is analyze. The first item starts to turn green, and you can see the total process at the bottom window. I'm not going to subject you to this in real time, but this one took about 5 minutes in total. So not something you want to sit and watch, but in the scheme of things, your real assistant would have taken much longer, and you'd be paying for their time as well. As the individual clips are completed, you'll be able to select the eye icon and see the keywords that have been created, as well as close-up, medium, and long shots. You can disable the keywords you don't want to record. But if you accept everything that's generated, and there's over 1,300 potential keywords used by the app, you'll have an overload of information when you import that into Final Cut, and you'll see that in a minute. Once you've rationalized the keywords you want, simply click Export FCP XML, and it defaults to the Documents folder. First use will ask for authorization. Now drag that XML file on top of Final Cut Pro, and it'll ask you what library you want to add it to. It creates a new event, and all the keywords are there for you to use. And you'll notice what I said about information overload, if you do not eliminate those unnecessary keywords before importing. This is a result with the keywords eliminated before the import into Final Cut Pro. Well worth the effort. $9.99, well spent. And to me, one of the most useful things about the app is it remembers all the keywords you've used previously. So for the future projects, you can call up keywords used in those previous projects. Simply select Search Archive from the window menu. Type in the keyword you want to retrieve from the archive. Click on the clips you want to use and save. Then import that into Final Cut as you'd done before. Working with audio, though, is quite different, and it's likely to be slower to generate keywords. It also requires more work to teach the app which words to ignore in the future. It'll take quite a few sessions to get this into some sort of working state, as you need to select the words you don't want memorized. And if you tick one by mistake, you can add that back to the tag of retained words. And the question is whether this is worth your time, and the answer to that is how much you'll use this feature. If just wanting to do once or twice, well, forget it. The more you have a need to use audio generation, the more useful it'll be. And as a bonus, though, if you're just looking for an audio transcription, this is seamless and will allow you to make changes like spelling to the transcript. There are many more detailed features and ways of personalizing the app. For instance, you can have a combination of words create their own keyword. And I'd suggest you use the tutorial number 5, Keyword Generators, and it's linked above, and this will take you to the app's website. So to wind up, overwhelmingly, FCP VideoTag is worth purchasing for those who are looking to have their keywords pre-analysed. I'd also say that it's a worthwhile purchase even if you're just wanting to create a transcript of your audio files. And I'd also suggest that you look at the other apps produced by the developer. If you're looking for one-on-one tuition with Final Cut Pro, just click on trainingfinalcutpro.com and I'll be happy to set up a personal training program for you. But if you're just looking for answers on a specific topic, then I can offer free Final Cut Pro support, that's via email, and that's for urgent issues that you're confronted with. Click the I above for a link to my free support site. And also let me know in the comments below if you've got some areas that you struggle with in Final Cut. I'd be happy to produce a video to solve those issues. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell. There are new videos every Sunday.